Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. The ability to generate structured data from unstructured inputs has become a crucial feature for AI applications. OpenAI introduced the JSON mode at their Dev Day last year, which improved model reliability to generating valid JSON outputs to benefit the follow-up agentic process. However, it didn't guarantee that the model's response would conform to a particular schema. To address this limitation, OpenAI has recently introduced a structured output in their API. This new feature ensures that the model-generated outputs exactly match JSON schemas provided by programs. Complex JSON schema follow-up evaluations, the new GPT-4o 2024 August 6 with structured outputs achieved 100% score compared to less than 40% for GPT-4 June 13, which has no structured output feature. While OpenAI has implemented this feature in GPT-4o, it's important to note that other models, including open source ones, can also benefit from similar capabilities. This tutorial focuses on using the Instructor library to enable structured output functionality for various models, not just for simple chatbots, but also for complex multi-agent applications like those built with the AutoGen framework. Instructor is a tool designed for generating structured outputs for language models. It offers simplicity, transparency, and user-centric design built on Pydantic. It supports the applications by managing validation and re-asking, retries, and streaming list and partial responses for UI rendering. In its core concept, Instructor combines function calling and Pydantic to create structured LLM outputs. It uses Pydantic's mechanism to define schemas and validate data in a single class, which makes it easier for developers to integrate into their AI agents-powered Python projects. First, install the latest Instructor, Pydantic, and OpenAI. First in the code, we will import the necessary libraries and set up our environment. Here we load the API key from OpenRouter. This low-cost inference platform allows users to call various open source models, including commercial models, with a high throughput via their API. You can acquire an API key from its website here. We'll use its OpenAI compatible API to quickly try how the instructor improves the output with reliable structure for those smaller LLM. Next in the code, we will define our designed output structure using a Pydantic model. This is one of the practical user cases that benefits from the structured output that concludes a final answer from separating reasoning steps. To implement that, we defined reasoning steps class using Pydantic's base model class. It contains two required fields, reasoning steps, which including a list of strings representing the steps in the reasoning process, and the answer, which is a string for the final conclusion. Both fields using Pydantic's field method for validation and documentation. Now we will set up the client by redirect the OpenAI function, which connects to the inference endpoint of OpenRouter. by using the instructor's construction method from OpenAI. Also, you can call other built-in methods like from Anthropic or from Gemini for Claude and Gemini models, and even Light LLM, which can be a proxy to your local models. For the model, here we specify open source model from Mistral AI, which is Mistral Large, and sets the response model to the reasoning steps class we defined previously. In our user message, we ask the model to compare three decimal numbers, 9.11, 9.9, and 9.10. The create function is called to generate a response based on these parameters, including reasoning steps and a final answer about which number is the largest, structured according to the reasoning steps class. Running this code will produce exactly the output we expect for a structured chain of thought process step by step. So let's see the output. Okay, you will see the reasoning steps. It's very clear that the first step is convert each decimal number into a comparable format that expand the two decimal places, because 9.9 only have one decimal place. And when they have the same decimal places, then compare results shows that 9.90 is greater than the other two. So the answer is 9.9 is the biggest number among these three numbers. Now let's explore how to integrate Instructor with the AutoGen framework to create agents that produce reliable structured output with confirmed skimmers. In this case, we will implement a quick two-agent application to make this tutorial simple and focused. First, don't forget to install the AutoGen package, PyAutoGen. In the code, as usual, we will import these libraries, including AutoGen, and set up the API key from OpenRouter. Next, we will define our structured output model using base model from PyLandic as previously. And this time we will formalize a basic persona from an employee's self-introduction. Here is the extracted info, including name, department, job title, location, and specialization. Now we will create a customer model client class that uses Instructor to generate structured output. This class definition is from the basic idea to recreate the model interface instead of using existing ones in AutoGen, because we need to replace the original model function with the instructor wrapped functions. According to AutoGen's definition for creating a customer model, the customer LLM client definition class is the minimum viable for a custom model class, including init, create, message retrieval, costs, and get usage. So the most critical one is the create function. Here we generate the response from the client that using the model from Google, the Gemma 2.9b instruction free model on OpenRouter, and we provide all the message history to the messages parameter, and also we give the extracted info class to the responsible model, and the rest of this creation function is to pack the response messages into a OpenAI aligned message structure. Then we will set up the config list for our custom model by setting the model class name to the model client CLS parameter, which is very important to register the custom model to the AutoGen agent. After that, now we can initialize our two agents. If you're familiar with AutoGen, it's very simple here. The user proxy that represents the user input and the assistant agent that powered by our custom model. It's another important code here is to register our model client to the agent. Finally, we will start a conversation by providing a self-introduction and let the agent extract the structured information. It's very simple. Self-introduction in a plain text. I'm Alice Johnson. I'm a senior digital strategist in the marketing department. My specializations include social media marketing, content strategy, and data analytics. I also dabble in SEO and email marketing. Then we can find the last information output from assistant and check its validation in JSON and print the output. After running this code, the extracted information is validated against the extracted info model we defined earlier. Let's see. Here, the user proxy sends the self-introduction and the assistant agent reply with a structured JSON format with a name, department, job title, location, and specialization, which is totally correct. So imagine you have more follow-up agents in your multi-agent application, and these agents will convert this structure to an external API service or data sheet or join a graph. Such structured output is even more useful for a multi-agent application, right? Using Instructor library, we can ensure that our AI agents produce structured outputs that conforms to predefined schemas. There are many more user cases we can implement by using structured outputs, from the text and image classification to the knowledge graph extraction, content moderation, and enhancing RAG systems through a query expansion and planning. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.